January's cryptocurrency sell-off got fresh impetus on Tuesday when Bitcoin slumped as much as 25%, as the prospect of regulatory crackdowns appeared to spread. While the largest digital coin was down 25% at $10,338 as of 4:37 p.m. in New York, it was still at the lowest level since early December, according to composite pricing on Bloomberg. As Bitcoin halted its 12-day rally, rival cryptocurrencies also tumbled. Ripple sank as much as 40% and Ethereum dropped 26%. Speculators across the globe are struggling to determine when DeFi market watchdogs may reign in an industry that's decentralized and derives much of its value from anonymous ownership. Many assertions that digital coins represent a bubble have triggered double-digit sell-offs over the past year, only to be followed by rebounds. In South Korea, shutting down cryptocurrency exchanges is still an option, Finance Minister Kim Dong-yeon said in an interview with TBS Radio. But measures first need serious discussion among ministries, Kim added, holding out hope for traders that a crackdown won't go that far. Kim said there's irrational speculation and that rational regulation was needed. The finance minister made it clear they're definitely considering banning crypto trading, and it's probably the third largest market, said Neil Wilson, senior market analyst in London for online trading platform ETX Capital. The news is hitting prices and broader sentiment, and it follows China's move to shutter mines. China, which first began targeting the industry last year, is escalating its clampdown on cryptocurrency trading, particularly online platforms and mobile apps that offer exchange-like services, according to people familiar with the matter. How China's stifling Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies quick take QA, we've heard reports that South Korea, China and Japan have considered a shared approach, a path, to regulation, ETX's Wilson said, also citing a challenge to digital coins from a bill in the US Senate. It looks like the light touch that has allowed the crypto boom to explode may be coming to an end, he wrote in a note to investors. Lower than normal trading in Korea and Japan may have exaggerated the moves in Asia hours on Tuesday, said Matty Greenspan, senior market analyst for the eToro currency platform. Bitcoin trading using the Korean won was about 3.3% of the total among major currencies, compared with more than 10% reached on several days over the past 2 weeks, according to CryptoCompare.com data. Stephen Mizor, chairman of the European Securities and Markets Authority, said investors should be prepared to lose all their money in Bitcoin in a Bloomberg TV interview in Hong Kong. It has an extremely volatile value, which undermines its use as a currency, he said. It's also not broadly accepted. For more on cryptocurrencies, check out the Decrypted podcast. The ESMA warned retail investors against initial coin offerings in November and is monitoring developments in cryptocurrencies, Mizor said.